हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग माय सनशाइंस ऑफ गुरुकुल इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल। हाउ आर यू टुडे? होप यू आर हैविंग अ ग्रेट डे एंड डूइंग गुड इन योर स्टडीज। किड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय इंग्लिश क्लास विद वन मोर इंटरेस्टिंग लेसन। चिल्ड्रन, आवर टुडेज लेसन इज अबाउट अ पर्सन हु वाज अ मेंडिकेट सेंट एंड अ सोशल रिफॉर्मर। Yes, kids, our today's lesson is all about Sant Gadge Maharaj. Gadge Maharaj was born on 23rd February 1876 in Shengaon, Maharashtra. His original name was Debuji Jingraji Janorkar. A public teacher, he traveled from one place to another, carrying his trademark broom. When he entered any village, he instantly start cleaning the gutters and roads. Villagers gave him money. With the help of that money, Maharaj built educational institutions, dharamshalas, hospitals and animal shelters. He told people to stop animal sacrifice as part of religious ritual. He conducted kirtans, and during his kirtan, he educated people against the rituals and blind faiths. He abandoned his family to pursue the path of hard work, simple living, and selfless service to the poor. The Postal Department of India had honored Gadge Maharaj by issuing a stamp in his name. Gadge Maharaj died on 20 December 1956 in Amravati, Maharashtra. Children, let's learn more about him. Lesson number 36, Gadge Maharaj. Gadge Baba was a modern saint. He lived many years ago, but he is still remembered for the great work he did in thousands of places. What did he look like? Silver hair, brown eyes, and fair skin. Big, tall, and stout body. Stout means rather fat. He wrapped a lungi around the waist and wore a torn but clean shirt. A cloth shoe adorned one foot while the other foot was many times bare. Adorned means decorated with. Bare means without any covering. He always carried a bowl and a stick. Because of this bowl or a gadge, people started calling him Gadge Baba or Gadge Maharaj. His real name was Debuji Jingraji Janorkar. He never stayed long in one place. He slept only on a rough blanket and used only his own arm as a pillow. He roamed from village to village, spreading his message of cleanliness, humanity, and the importance of education. He was not only bothered by hunger or thirst. What he liked was bhajan, kirtan, and teaching people. Thousands of people flocked to listen to his kirtan. Roam means walked or travel with no particular purpose. Humanity means kindness or consideration for others. Flocked means gathered, come together. His kirtans used to be very lively. He would not simply give lectures. Lively means interesting. Lectures means a speech or talk to a group of people on a particular subject. He would often ask questions to the audience to keep up their interest. Audience means people who gather to listen to something. Then he would show them how absurd they were in their words and actions. For example, he would ask, how many gods are there? One, you worship Khandoba, Masoba, Viroba and Vetal and so on. You worship many more, don't you? Yes, your action shows that you believe that there are number of gods. And yet you said a little while ago that you worship one god. Were you asleep then? Absurd means not seeming proper or real. The audience would be taken by surprise. Then they would listen more attentively to Baba. Baba would say, "You offer things to God in return for His favor, don't you?" "Yes, we do." "And don't you say, 'God, my child is ill. Please make him well. I will offer you a goat.'" "Yes, we do." "And won't you say that if God lets go the two-legged child, you will offer him in return a four-legged animal?" "We do." "Why? Can God, who created this world, be so cruel? Can he be so greedy? Can he be bribed?" "No." "Do you think killing and eating one of the God's creatures will please him? Will he bless you for that?" Bribe means to pay money to someone to make him or her do something dishonest. Then the audience would realize how wrong their thinking was. They would promise to be more thoughtful. After the kirtan, people flocked to touch Gadge Baba's feet. But he won't allow anyone to do that. He did not like people touching his feet. As soon as the kirtan was over, he sped away, leaving the crowds far behind. "Develop good qualities, that's all. There's no point in touching my feet," he said. Sped away means went away very quickly. Baba followed one rule to the end of his life. Wherever he went, be it a village, town or small settlement, he asked for sturdy brooms, spades and pans. Sturdy means strong. Then he would sweep and clean the whole area. Soon the other people joined him, but he did not wait for that to happen. He started sweeping and cleaning the place himself. And if any bystander tried to bow to Baba while he was busy in his work, that person would get a smack of the broom on the back. Bystander means a person standing near but not taking part in what is happening. Smack means a hit, usually with open hand, given as punishment. You don't do any of this work yourself, and when somebody else tries to do it, you put yourself in the way. Move aside. See how nice and welcoming this village looks when it is clean. If you visit a holy place in Maharashtra like Pandharpur or Nasik or Dehu or Alandi, you will see the work Gadge Baba did in these places. He himself worked hard, asked for people and built free boarding places. Boarding places means places where one can sleep and eat at low cost. Ghats on the rivers and water spouts. For the poor, helpless, disabled and the needy, he started places that offered food free of cost. He built schools, colleges and hostels for children. He saw God in the poor and miserable people. Serving these people was his way of serving God. Children, Sant Gadge Baba was the great hero of 19th century and known for his social services. He was a holy saint who worked for helpless and poor. His teaching were: give food to the hungry, give shelter to the needy, protect the environment. So children, you should also help the poor and the needy persons, and work hard in your life. We will end our class here today. Take care. Goodbye, kids. Hello, rise and shine, my tiny tots of Gurukul English Medium School. Children, I am back with my English class with one more new and interesting poem. The name of the poem is Bedtime. Kids, bedtime means the usual time when someone goes to bed. Children, it is a time when sun sets and night is going to come. When all human beings and creatures go back to their home. Children, just tell me, when you have your breakfast? Yes, in the morning. And when you have your lunch? Yes, in the afternoon. And when you have your dinner? Good, at night. And after having your dinner, what you do? Yes, you go to your bed. And kids, that is your bedtime. So kids, let's see who all are having their bedtime in the poem. First, I will read out the poem for you, then I will explain it to you. Lesson number 37, Bedtime. The evening is coming, the sun sinks to set, the rooks are all flying straight home to the nest. Cow, says the rook, as he flies overhead, it's time, little people, we're going to bed. The butterfly drowsy has folded its wing, the bees are returning, no more the birds sing. Their labor is over, their nestlings are fed, it's time, little people, we're going to bed. Good night, little people. Good night and good night. Sweet dreams to your eyelids. Till dawning of light, the evening has come. There's no one more to be said. It's time, little people, we're going to bed. Children, one more time we will read the poem. The evening is coming, the sun sinks to set, the rooks are all flying straight home to the nest. Cow, says the rook, as he flies overhead, it's time, little people, we're going to bed. The butterfly's drowsy has folded its wing, the bees are returning, no more the birds sing. Their labor is over, their nestlings are fed, it's time, little people, we're going to bed. Good night, little people, good night and good night. Sweet dreams to your eyelids, till dawning of light, the evening has come, there's no more to be said. It's time, little people, we're going to bed. Children, there are few rhyming words in the poem. Rest, nest. Overhead, bed. Wing, sing. Fed, bed. Night, light. Said, bed. The evening is coming, the sun sinks to rest, the rooks are all flying straight home to the nest. Cow, says the rook, as he flies overhead, it's time, little people, we're going to bed. Rook means a kind of bird. The poet says the entire day is over and evening is coming and the sun is setting. The rooks are flying back to their nest. As the rook flies in the sky and with the sound of cow, it says that it is time for the all little children to go to their bed. The butterfly drowsy has folded its wings, the bees are returning, no more the birds sing. Their labor is over, their nestlings are fed, It's time little people were going to bed. Drowsy means sleepy. Labor means hard work. Nestling means young birds which have not yet left their nest. The sleepy butterfly has folded its wing and the bees are returning to their hives. The birds have stopped singing. All of them have finished their work and the little baby birds in the nest have been fed by their mother. They too are ready to sleep and it's time the little children were going to their bed. Good night, little people. Good night and good night. Sweet dreams to your eyelids till dawning of light. The evening has come. There's no more to be said. It's time little people were going to bed. The poet wishes all the lovely children good night and sweet dreams till eve is day again. He says that the evening has come and there should be no more talk because it's time for the little children to go to their bed. Children, bedtime routine are important for children's age. Regular schedule and bedtime rituals help us get the sleep we need and give us the ability to work hard. When it comes to children, it is important to have a routine of bedtime. This is all for today. Take care. Goodbye, kids. Good morning, my lovely kids. How are you all? Hope you are good and doing your studies well. Kids, we are at the end of our portion. So hope you all are prepared for your exams. Kids, you all know about magic. Yes, we have studied this in most of our subjects and lessons. You all have heard many stories about magic. Today in my English class, we will learn one more new and interesting lesson, that is lesson number 38, The Magic Kettle. Children, it is a story about an animal, how he turns into a kettle, how his mischievous acts make someone irritated and someone rich. So children, let's learn and understand the story. Lesson number 38, The Magic Kettle. A tanuki is a small, furry, dog-like animal found in Japan. There are many imaginary stories about this playful little animal. It is believed in the stories that a tanuki can take the shape of anything or any animal. Here is a story about a tanuki and a peddler called Jimmu. Peddler means a person who sells things from door to door. Once in the country of Japan, there lived an old man. He lived in a very beautiful house high up in the mountain. He was proud of his house with its white straw mats and pretty papered walls. In warm weather, he slid back the walls to let the smell of the trees and the flowers come in. Slid means moved easily. One day he was standing looking at the mountain opposite when he heard a kind of rumbling noise in the room behind him. Rumbling means making a low continuous sound. He turned around and saw a rusty old iron kettle in a corner. Rusty means covered with rust, the reddish brown layer that forms on old iron articles. How the kettle got there, the old man did not know, but he picked it up and looked it over carefully. "That's a piece of luck," he said, smiling to himself. "My old kettle was getting worn out and he looked like a good kettle." He filled the new kettle with water and put it on the fire. As soon as the water in the kettle began to get warm, a strange thing happened. The man thought it must be dreaming. The handle of the kettle slowly changed its shape and became a head. The spout became into a tail. Out of the body of the kettle sprang four paws. In a few minutes, the man was watching not a kettle but a tanuki. The tanuki jumped off the fire and bounded about the room like a kitten. Bounded about means jumped about here and there. It ran up the pretty papered walls and even across the ceiling. The old man could not catch it. He called his neighbor for help. Somehow they caught the tanuki and shut it up in a wooden chest. Running after the tanuki had made them both very tired. They sat down on the mat to rest. Chest means a large, strong box made of wood which is used for storing goods. What shall I do with this naughty animal? I don't want to keep it in the house, said the old man. Why don't you sell it off to Jimmu, the peddler? The neighbor suggested. That's a good idea, said the old man. So they sent for Jimmu. When he came, the old man went to the chest and lifted the lid very, very carefully. But there was no tanuki inside, only the old rusty kettle the old man had found. He did not now want to keep the kettle. He gave it away to Jimmu without taking any money for it. Jimmu put the kettle in his cloth bag and started off home. He felt that his bag was getting heavier and heavier on the way, but he did not put it down. On reaching home, Jimmu put the bag away carefully in a corner. At night, when Jimmu was fast asleep, he heard a sudden noise and woke up. He could not see anything, but he thought he heard some noises in the corner. When he lit the lamp, he saw that the kettle had turned into a tanuki once again. It was running round chasing its own tail. It ran here and there and jumped and turned somersault. Somersault means a movement in which somebody turns over completely with their feet over their head. Jimmu sat watching the tanuki for a long time. Then he fell asleep. When he got up in the morning, he saw that the tanuki had not run away. The old kettle was still there, lying in a corner. He picked it up lovingly. "Do you wish to stay with me, tanuki?" he asked. To his surprise, the tanuki answered in a human voice, "I will stay with you and make you very rich. You can show me around. People will give a lot of money to see a kettle turned into a tanuki and dance." So that's what they did. Jimmu set up a booth with a platform. He put the kettle on the platform. Booth means small tent or building in a market. At his command, the kettle turned into a tanuki. At Jimmu's command, the little furry animal would then walk, run, jump, leap, turn somersaults or dance. People loved to see the kettle change into a playful little animal that could do all things. This paid Jimmu very well to see the show. Big crowds of people came to watch the show, and the dear little tanuki never disappointed them. Merrily, it danced many times. The shadow dance, the fan dance, the umbrella dance, it never tried off dancing. Soon, Jimmu had collected lots and lots of money. He had become a very rich man. He said to the Tanuki, "Dear Tanuki, you have made me a rich man. We can both live in comfort now. We can stop the shows if you like." So they decided to stop the shows. But Jimmu did not forget the old man who had given him the magic kettle. He gave some of the money to the old man. All of them lived long and happy lives. Jimmu and the old man are now no more, but you may still come across the magic kettle lying in a corner somewhere in Japan. Friend, how was the story? Hope you enjoyed it. Kids, magic is always a fun-loving thing for all of us. It gives us an excitement to hear about it. Kids, this is our last lesson of English. Now, you have to be prepared for your upcoming exams, oral as well as written. All the best, kids. Goodbye.